Hi all, welcome back to computer science class. This is our lesson 3, control structures in C, and this is our session 2 in lesson 3. So this will be the last session in your lesson 3. Good morning, busy in your works? Okay, let's have a quick recap of the previous session. So what are the things we have studied in the previous? Yes, we have studied about sequence control structure and selection control structures. So this unit deals with control structure, and we have already studied about two control structures, sequence and selection. So selection, we have 5 different types. One is if else if, nested if, and switch statement. All these 5 types we have studied in your previous session with some examples. Okay, now let's start listening to today's class. So this is our chapter 3, control structures in C. And today's key concept, we are going to deal with the third type, that is your iteration control structure. So we have already studied about the sequence, that is nothing but a step by step. And second one is our selection, that is nothing but whether a true or false statement you are going to execute based on that. And third thing is your iteration control structure. So this is the types of iteration control structures: for, nested for, while, do while. All these types we are going to study. So these types, with an example, flowchart, and a syntax, we'll be dealing in this. So at the end of this session, the main objective we are going to deal with is the iteration control structure and its working with an example. Okay, so first, what is a loop or an iteration? So what is meant by an iteration? So in general, statements are executed sequentially, that is the one after the another. If first statement is executed, after the completion of its execution, then it will move on to the second one and then to the next statements. But instead of going in a sequential order, when you are going to have a block of codes need to be executed several number of times, then we use loop. So when we want to go for your multiple operations, okay, for multiple times we are going to execute it, then we'll be using this iteration. It is otherwise called as loop. Okay, this loop simplifies complex problems into easier one. So it allows to alter the flow of the program. So it executes a statement or a group of statement multiple times. So it is going to execute n number of times, so that n will be denoted in your condition. So until that given condition returns false, in the sense, whenever the number of times has reached its limit, then it will be stopping its execution. Okay, so what is the main advantage of using this? For example, if you need to print first 10 natural numbers, okay, so instead of using the printf statement 10 times, so printf 1, printf 2, printf 3, so instead of using that 10 times, you put the one single printf statement inside a loop. So this loop will run n number of times and it will be printing it 10 times. Okay, so the main advantage is code reusability. That is, instead of using 10 times printf, you are going to use only one time printf. That is your code reusability. And not needed to write the code again and again. So same printf statement is not repeated. So only one single statement it is being used. And traversed over the elements of data structure. So this data structure you will be dealing in your higher classes. So already you have studied about this arrays. So in our next session, we'll be dealing with array. So array is nothing but a collection of similar data structure. You are going to traverse, in the sense you are going to move on or deal with the elements present in this array. So these are the advantages of using a loop or an iteration. So the next thing we have is 3 main operations in a loop. So to write a loop statement, we have 3 main operations. only these three operations will be followed for each and every loop. You are going to have some representation variation. So for for loop, it will be having one representation. While and do while, all these types will have various representation, but the basic common thing is this three main operation. So what are those things? First, initialization. So you have to initialize a value. So start with one or start with a zero, the starting point, that is your initialization. And second thing is checking for condition. That means till what we have to print. So till what we have to run the iteration or the loop. So that is your checking for condition. So this is testing expression that is used to determine whether the loop should continue or to be terminated. So this, whether this is the end point or still you have to move on with the iteration. So that is being given in your checking for condition. And third thing is your increment and decrement operator. So increment and decrement, in the sense you will have studied about this operator, plus plus, minus minus. Yes, it is going to increase the value by one or whatever denotation you have specified. If you specify I is equal to I plus 2, which means you are incrementing the values by two numbers. Okay, so it changes the value of looping variable. The variable which you are initialized, it will be changed according to this increment or decrement operation. So only these three things you have to remember in your loop. One is your initialization, second one is checking for condition, and third one is your increment and decrement operation. So I'll show this, how it is being represented in all these different loops. Okay, so first, look at this. You have some values that is being printed over here. So what is this? Yes, it is a for loop. So here in the for loop, it is an entry check loop, which means it will be checking the condition at the first itself while entering itself. See this example, a is equal to 1, a is less than 5. So it will be checking whether it is less than 5. It will be checking the condition. Once the condition is satisfied, then only it will be moving on to the block that is present inside this. So that's why it is called as entry check loop. You are checking at the initial stage itself. So for example, whenever you move on into a company, you will be using your access card. Only when your access card works properly, then only you can go inside the company, or else you have to come out. So similarly, you are checking at the entrance itself, whether it is correct or not. Okay, so it contains, I have told, the three main operations, the initialization, checking for condition, and increment decrement. So this initialization, testing, and modifier expressions within a single set of parentheses. So it will be given in a single statement itself, all the three things. Initialization, that is A is equal to 1. Testing is nothing but A is less than 5, the condition. And modifier expressions is nothing but it is executed at the end of iteration. So after executing this body part, it will be executing this increment or decrement operation. Okay. So the syntax for loop is, for initialization, everything should be terminated with a semicolon. Semicolon condition, semicolon increment and decrement, and the statements within the for loop. So you might have one doubt. If the for loop, for all the C statements, you should terminate with a semicolon. So if you terminate a semicolon here, what will happen? Yes, it will be executing only once. It won't go for multiple times, since you have terminated with a semicolon. So for a for loop, you should not terminate with a semicolon at the end, since it has to execute the multiple blocks of code. Okay, so this is your flowchart. First initialization, you have to check the condition, then go for the statements within it. Then you are going to increment. After incrementing, again, it has to come back to check the condition. Then if it is false, it will be moving out. If it is true, it will be printing the statements. Okay, let us see one example here. See, I is equal to 0. From 1 to 10, it is going to print. So I is equal to 1, I is less than equal to 10, and I plus plus, this is your, what is this? This is your initialization, testing for condition, and increment and decrement operator, and it will be printing the values here. So this will be your output. It will be printing 1 to 10. Okay. So nested for loop. So for loop is nothing but a single for statement or single execution. Nested for loop is nothing but it is a loop within another loop. Nesting itself means one inside the another. Okay, you are going to have, you have seen a nest. How it will be? Yes, it will be having multiple threads all interconnected together. So that is your nesting. Yes. Similarly, here the loop also will have another loop inside it. So it is a logical structure used in programming where you have two repeating statements are placed in a nested form. It is not necessary to have only two. You might have more than two also. So instead of going for one statement, if you go for multiple statements, then it is called as nesting. Okay. So whenever the inner loop completes, the outer loop is executed for its second iteration. So it will be moving on like that way only. Inside, from inside to the next outside, next outer, only the last, the first outer will be executed once every inner part is being completed. Okay. So look at the syntax. So a for loop for initialization, condition and increment, decrement. Again, you have another for loop within it. This is your nesting. So first, it will be executing this inner for loop, the statements. Once this condition is false, it will be moving on to the first for loop and it will be executing those statements. Okay. So this is your flowchart. So initialization, first check for the first condition, then go for the second for loop condition, then execute the statements, increment and decrement. Once this becomes false, then it will be moving on to the first for loop. Okay. So example program, see, I is equal to 0, j is equal to 0. So two for loops, you are going to print two different values. So first 0, 0, 0, 1. So all these things will be printed for the for loop. Okay. So the next thing, see, look at this. The representation of the operations differs here. So here you have initialization at the first, condition at the second, and increment, decrement at the last part. So this is your, yes, good. It is a while loop. So it is also an entry check loop. So you are going to check the condition at the starting stage itself. So at the first itself, you will be checking the condition, then only you will be moving on inside the block. So the test expression are enclosed within this parenthesis. So here it is given in the parenthesis. The statement in the loop is executed till the condition is true. Once the condition is false, it will be coming out of this loop statement. Okay. So when the condition fails, the loop will be terminating. So that's why it is called as entry check loop. Okay. So the syntax for loop is first initialization, the operation, three operations, the first initialization will be coming first. Then while the expression is nothing but the condition checking and then the statements within it, then you have this increment and decrement within this loop. And this is your flowchart. First itself, you will be checking the condition. Then if it is true, you will be executing the statements. If it is false, it will be coming out of it. So see this example. So I is equal to 1, when I is less than 10, that is 1 is less than 10, then only it will be printing the values. Otherwise, it will be coming out. So this is your output. So next, look at this. So this is your do while loop. In do while loop, there is no condition checking at the initial part. So what it is going to do is, it is an exit check loop. It will be checking the condition at the exit part. So it will be not checking the condition at the initial phase. That means when you can execute the statements within the do while loop once. Because once when the condition is false, it will be coming out of the loop. But the condition itself is being checked at the end part. So it means you can't execute the condition at the initial stage. Okay, so it will be executing once, the statements will be executed. So if the condition is false after the first iteration, the loop terminates. So first time, once it will be executing, it will be lastly checking the condition. If it is false, it will be coming out of the loop. Okay, so this is your syntax. So the first one is initialization, do. You are going to do the statements within it and at last you will be checking the condition. If it is false, it will be moving on to the next part. So this is your flowchart. So for the previous one and this one, the main difference is for the while statement, you have the condition over here and then the statements. But in do statement, you have the statements at the first and then only it will be checking your condition. If it is true, it will be moving on to the statements. If it is false, it will be coming out of the loop. Okay. So the example for this is, do, so which means it will be printing, if the condition is false, it will be printing the first value, okay, because it will be entering into the do loop and then only it will be checking for the condition. So this will be your output. Okay, now the difference between while and do while. So the while is an entry check, that is it checks the condition and then executes the statements, but do while is it executes the statements at least once before checking the condition. So which means it will be printing some values and then only it will be checking for the condition. Okay, so this is your difference, main difference between while and do while loop. So let us see example programs for all these looping statements. To go inside the example programs, to do the example programs, what you have to do? Yes, you have to open a C editor, Turbo C. I have opened a blank page, new page. Now let's start typing the programs for all the loops. So first, dash include. stdio.h and dash include conio.h, and you have this void main. So I'm initializing one integer value, I is equal to 1. Okay, I'm giving clear screen for clearing my screen. And I'm using for loop first. What is the statement for for loop syntax? Yes, the initialization at the first, I is equal to 1. I is, this is your condition checking. I is less than equal to 10. And you have to separate it with a semicolon. I plus plus. So I plus plus, then I'm printing this I value. Print of percentage B, comma. I'm printing this I value. Okay. I'm giving getch to show my output. And then I'm closing this loop. So what is the statement given here? You have to print 1 to 10 numbers. Okay. So let me check. First, I have to compile it. So first compile it, then run the program. See, it will be printing 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So it is printing in the same line. So I'll be giving this slash n, which will be printing in the next line. See, look at this. Yes, one by one, it will be printing. Okay, so this is your for loop. See, even you can have this increment as 2 to increment. So if you give I is equal to I plus 2, what will happen to the output? Let us check. 1, 3, 5, 7, 9. So all the odd numbers will be printed. We have started with 1. So 2 increment, that is 3, then 5. So 2 to increment, it will be printing. So this is your for loop. Okay. Now let us do with a while loop. So what is the initialization I have done here? Int I is equal to 1 and while, the same set of statements I am giving. While I is less than 10. So this is your condition checking. I'm giving this printf, and at the end, you have to give this I plus plus. Okay. So this is your initialization part. Then the condition checking. Then increment operation. Okay. So first let me compile it. And then let me run it. So see. It will be printing 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Yes. So similarly for do while. So do while. You have to give do here and then the condition at the last. While I is less than 10. The condition should be given at the last. So first compile it. Then
run the program. So say 1, 2, 3 till 9. Okay. So let me show this condition. I is less than equal to 1. Okay. So for do while, what is happening here? Let us check whether it will be printing or not. Will it print anything? Yes, good. It will be printing 1 because it won't check the condition at the initial stage. It will be going into the do loop. It will be printing I. What is the value of I initialized here? 1. So it will be printing 1. Then only it will be checking the condition whether it is less than 1. So 1 is less than 1? No. The condition is false. So it will be coming out of the loop. So it will be printing once. But for the while loop, it won't print anything. Okay. So now let us see one example for for loop. That is nested for loop. So this is your, what is this? Yes. Command statement, multi-line command. It will be not highlighting your statements. So for I is equal to 1, I is less than equal to 10, I plus plus. So not 10, let me go with some less values. I plus plus. Okay. Another for loop. For I'm initializing another variable, j is equal to 1. You should use a different variable. J is less than equal to, I'm giving I. Let me check what is happening here. So j plus plus. So give printf. Inside the loop, you have to print the j value, percentage d slash t. So tab, comma, j value. And outside the inner for loop, I'm giving one more printf statement. Percentage d slash n for new line, slash t for tab, and I value, and close this for loop. And one more thing, I haven't declared j variable, so I have to declare this j variable I comma j. Okay, so first let us compile. Yes, and then let us run the program. Yes, look at this, it will be printing a step by step. So we have seen it is a matrix representation or anything representing in rows and columns that is being given in your nested for loop. Okay, so you can print this pattern. Whatever method you want, you can print it. So you can change this J and I interchange and check what is happening. Okay. So these are the example programs for all the looping statements. Now, a quick recap. So what we have studied? Yes, it is a control structure. In that we have studied iteration control structure. And what are the types we have seen in iteration control structure? While, do while, for, and a nested for. So you have exit check and entry check. So which one is an exit check? Very good. It is the while, do while loop. So do while loop will be your exit check. So it will be executing the statements once and then only it will be checking the condition at the end. That's why it is called as exit. An entry check, what are the loops that is an entry check? Yes, while, for, and nested for will be your entry check loop. So these are the looping statements we have studied with the syntax and the examples. Okay, now it's time for assessment or activity. Okay, to do the assessment, what you have to do? Yes, you have to join the Google Classroom. This is your code ZSBQHFU and you'll be joining your 9th standard computer science class. And this time, there is an activity. You have a memory game in your near pot. You just play this game. You have to match the pairs. So that is being given as an activity here. Try this. You just copy this link and then give enter. It will be moving on to that site and you can play that memory game. And you have an assignment. You have to write a C program to print first 10 natural numbers using this for while and do while loop. So what example I have taught in this video, the same example I have given as an assignment, just make a note of those programs. And similarly, to print multiplication table using nested for loop. So I have printed 1, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, the pattern. You can use the same program or else you can go for this multiplication table. That is any table, 2 table, 3 table, whatever table you can print it. Just make a try. Okay, I'll give the sample program in your exercise, book back exercise. I'll give this answer. Okay, just make a try or else copy the program which I have executed in your demo. Okay, so that's all with today's class. So with this, our session chapter 3, control structures in C, has come to an end. For the next session, we'll be dealing with the same C programming but arrays and functions. Okay, stay home, stay safe. Thank you, children. Thank you.